out of that three relation that Sambhaji had with the foreign power, like Portuguese, Sindhi, and Mughal, we will first deal with the Sambhaji and Mughal relation because that is the most important and that is the longest conflict that Sambhaji had with any other political power in India. See, one important thing is that it is not that he dealt first with Sindhi and then he dealt later on with Portuguese and later on he dealt with Mughal. Many times he was engaged in conflict simultaneously. In fact, Sindhi, which is a separate independent topic in your syllabus, Sindhi was an ally of Mughal. He was vassal of Mughal, and that is the relation, the conflict between Sambhaji and Sindhi. Though we will be dealing it as a separate unit, there is an interconnectivity, there is an entanglement with the Mughal. Similarly, Mughal, when they attacked Sambhaji, they did send their ambassador to Portuguese, asking them for help or asking them to remain neutral. So let us go at first with the relation between Sambhaji and Mughal. So far, we have studied about Shivaji. The first unit was, second unit was completely on Shivaji. This is the third unit now. So Shivaji, he does this in 1680. And after that, there was conflict in the Maratha kingdom. Who was supposed to become next Chhatrapati? So Sambhaji's eldest son, Shivaji's eldest son was Sambhaji. And during the coronation, जब शिवाजी का राज्याभिषेक हुआ था 1674 में, उस समय संभाजी को जो उत्तराधिकारी घोषित कर दिया गया था, he was declared as successor. But there were certain things, there were certain behavior of Sambhaji, which was not liked by the ministers of Shivaji. उस संभाजी के हाथ से कुछ गलतियां ऐसे हो गई थी, जिसके कारण शिवाजी के जो मंत्री थे, वो संभाजी को पसंद नहीं करते थे और उन्होंने एक षड्यंत्र किया कि शिवाजी की मृत्यु के बाद में जो मराठों का राजा बनेगा वो संभाजी नहीं होगा बल्कि राजाराम होगा, जबकि राजाराम बहुत छोटा था. और ये थोड़ा सा बैकग्राउंड हम लोग देखेंगे. संभाजी का जन्म 1657 में हुआ था और 1689 में उसको औरंगजेब ने उसकी हत्या कर दी. तो मराठों के इतिहास में संभाजी थोड़ा सा एक कॉन्ट्रोवर्सियल कैरेक्टर जरूर है. वो जब काफी छोटे थे, 2 साल के थे, उस समय उनकी मदर की, उनकी माँ जो थी, सईबाई, सईबाई निम्बालकर की बेटी थी, शी डाइड एंड ही वॉज डिप्रीड ऑफ लव ऑफ मदर एंड ही वॉज ब्रॉटअप बाई जीजाबाई. शिवाजी के जो मदर थी जीजाबाई, उन्होंने उनका संगोपन किया था. और 1665 में, अगर आपको याद है, यू मस्ट बी रिमेम्बरिंग दैट देर वॉज एन इम्पोर्टेंट ट्रीटी ऑफ पुरंदर दैट वॉज साइन बिटवीन शिवाजी एंड मुगल. 1664 में जय सिंह, अ वेरी केपेबल कमांडर ऑफ मुगल, वॉज सेंट टू महाराष्ट्र अगेंस्ट शिवाजी विथ अ ह्यूज आर्मी, जय सिंह एंड दिलेर खान. And Jai Singh has managed to bring Shivaji on the, you know, on his knees almost. Shivaji has surrendered. And but during this treaty, during this negotiation, Shivaji said ki, I will not become Mansabdar of Mughal. I will serve the Mughal, but in place of me, let my son become Mansabdar. And it was Sambhaji who was made Mansabdar. So, you know, somehow one after another things just started happening, and that created a kind of rift or mistrust between father and son. The first thing is that Sambhaji was not having mother. And then Shivaji's another wife, Soyrabai, whose son was Rajaram, she somehow started dreaming that if I can, you know, sideline Sambhaji. And it will be better that after Shivaji, my son Raja Ram should become Chhatrapati. Now, Sambhaji probably on his part thought that Shivaji, he doesn't want to become Mansabdar, but he is sending me as a Mansabdar, which is quite an insulting thing to do. Then, along with Shivaji, it was Sambhaji who, as a child, accompanied Shivaji to Agra. Then, from there, they both escaped. But later on, also after Shivaji escaped from Agra in 1666, Shivaji wrote a letter to Aurangzeb and he said that I still follow that treaty of Purandar and I am ready to send an army under the command of my son to serve the Mughal. So Mughal important outpost in south was Aurangabad. And at Aurangabad में संभाजी के नेतृत्व में मराठों की सेना भेजी गई जो कि मुगलों की मदद करती थी. तो ही स्टेड संभाजी स्टेड इन द मुगल कैंप एंड ही मेड फ्रेंडशिप विद द मुगल प्रिंस ऑल्सो. एंड लेटर ऑन लाइक एज आई ऑलरेडी वी हैव ऑलरेडी रिपीटेड ड्यूरिंग द कोरोनेशन सेरेमनी ऑफ 1674, कोरोनेशन सेरेमनी ऑफ शिवाजी, ही वॉज डिक्लेयर्ड एज अ क्राउन प्रिंस द नेक्स्ट सक्सेसर. But somehow that mistrust it grew because during the expedition, Karnataka expedition, you know, after the coronation, Shivaji undertook Karnataka expedition where he conquered the Karnataka area of Bijapur Sultan. And as Shivaji went away from Maratha towards Karnataka, he formed the Council of Minister. And as it was a practice, see, Jizabai was no more. So earlier it was Jizabai who looked after the kingdom during the absence of Shivaji. When Shivaji was absent and went to Agra during 1665-66, it was Jizabai who looked after the kingdom with the help of the minister. But now when Jizabai was no longer, it was supposed to be a crown prince Sambhaji who is supposed to look after the kingdom. And but instead of keeping Sambhaji at Raigad, the administration was handed over to Council of Minister, and Shivaji asked Sambhaji to remain away from Raigad. He was first kept at place called Pachad, and then he was asked to spend time with Samarth Ramdaswamy at Sajjangarh. Now this has again created rift between the father and son, and you know there was certain allegation against Sambhaji that he was addicted, and even we don't have concrete evidences, but there was an allegation that even he molested a Brahmin married daughter who came to his father's. So we are not pretty sure about it. It doesn't have much of historical evidences. But there were numerous reasons that these ministers of Shivaji, they did not trust Sambhaji too much. And it was also believed that he is a worshipper of Shakta Panth, worshipper of tantric. So then he also had a friend called Kavi Kalash, who was North Indian Brahmin, and probably he has developed a very good friendship with Sambhaji. And the Marathas, they treated this person from north as a kind of outsider and did not really like him. So in order to avoid this kind of conflict between Sambhaji and minister, probably Chhatrapati Shivaji has asked Sambhaji to stay away from Raigad and spend his time with the religious person like Ramdas Swami. But somehow things did not work out well, and Sambhaji, who started feeling that he's being sidelined or what, for whatever reason might be, and as Sambhaji was as a Mansabdar had spent some time in the Mughal camp, Diler Khan, the Mughal commander the Mughal commander who was in South India, somehow he says that kind of discontentment, and then he started correspondence with Sambhaji, and he tried to encourage the kind of discontentment against his own father. And as a result, we find that Sambhaji one day he left the Maratha kingdom and he joined hands with Mughal. That was quite shocking for the Maratha nobility, that Shivaji, who is with a very hard work, who declared himself to be an independent king, and his own son is joining hands with the mortal enemy of the Marathas, that is Mughal. Well, but during that expedition, like as Sambhaji came to the Mughal camp, Diler Khan, he attacked Swaraj, Shivaji's kingdom, and during that attack, Sambhaji accompanied Diler Khan, and then he saw that Diler Khan, he is conquering fort after another fort, and he is inflicting a lot of atrocities on the people, innocent people. At Bhupalgarh, which was a Maratha fort of Shivaji, was conquered by Mughal, and there were a number of people who surrendered, and Diler Khan have punished them by chopping off one hand of all those 700 people, and this was not liked by Sambhaji. Sambhaji, he protested, and even that became one of the reason of the conflict between Sambhaji and Diler Khan. And it is even believed that they almost came to the blows, and Now, Aurangzeb was also very restless, and Aurangzeb did not trust that Sambhaji has really came to the Mughal. He believed that probably there is a conspiracy, and then he sent an order that Sambhaji should be arrested. But Sambhaji had his own well-wishers in the Mughal camp, maybe Dilir Khan, and Dilir Khan or somebody gave him a hint that you are going to be arrested, so it's better we escape. And Sambhaji escaped from the Mughal camp. He goes to Adil Shah first, and then he comes back to his own father. And then they meet each other. Now, Sambhaji was placed at Panara and Chhatrapati Shivaji. This happened in 1678. Now, Sambhaji was placed at Panara and he was under the watch. Like, you know, Chhatrapati Shivaji had his own people. He was not, of course, under the arrest, but there were certain restrictions on him that you should not just move around like that. You should stay at Panara. And when this was the situation, when Shivaji died suddenly at Raigad in 1680. Now, as these ministers, they were against Sambhaji becoming king. Sambhaji वो लोग नहीं चाहते थे कि राजा बने, and they put on the throne Rajaram. Soyrabai, Rajaram's mother, Shivaji's second wife. She was one of the conspirator, and there were number of people, ministers of Shivaji like Morappan Thupingale and Annaji Dutto. They were definitely supporters of Maratha kingdom, but they did not like Sambhaji, and they placed Rajaram on the throne. But though these ministers have, placed Rajaram on throne at Raigad, Sambhaji at Panara, he got the hint of all that conspiracy. He got the news of death of his father, though Soyrabai tried to hide it. And then he took control of Panara because he was being a crown prince. The Kiledar of Panara had no courage to put him under arrest or something of that sort. There was a chaos. There was a chaotic condition, and the camp was divided. There were definitely certain supporter of Sambhaji, and the very important supporter of Sambhaji was Hambi Rao Mohite. He was commander in chief. The main Senapati of Maratha army, and he joins hands with Sambhaji, and as a result we find that Sambhaji's military strength have increased, and as the army which was sent from Raigad to Panara to capture Sambhaji, they were defeated by Sambhaji like Morapanta and some of those conspirator, and they were arrested by Sambhaji. And Sambhaji from Panara, he goes to Raigad, the capital of Marathas, and many people joined hands with him because they generally believed that it is Sambhaji, the elder and grown-up son of Shivaji, who is more capable to become Chhatrapati and not a child, Rajaram. And his mother, Soyrabai, they definitely people will not like to be ordered. That was psychology. People will not like to be ordered by a woman, even there is already a grown-up crown prince who can be a king. And Soyrabai and Rajaram, they were arrested and they were put, if not in a very torturous prison, but they were kept in the confinement. They are not supposed to move freely. But somebody took good care of Rajaram's education and all. But these people who have conspired against Sambhaji first, and Sambhaji arrested some of them. But they indulged into another conspiracy. They tried to poison Sambhaji, and when later on. And when that conspiracy was revealed, when it came out, and all those people who were involved in that conspiracy were revealed, Sambhaji now gave a very heavy punishment. Some of them were killed, and even when Soyrabai, she felt that her conspiracy is exposed, she swallowed poison and she committed suicide. But now here onwards, Sambhaji, he became more increasingly dependent on a person who came from outside, Kavi Kalash, and he was not liked by the Marathas, and neither he was very capable. He was a poet by nature. He was not a good administrator, neither a good commander, military commander. Well, now when all this thing was happening, what brought already, as you know, the political situation was that political condition ऐसे थी कि मराठों का और मुगलों का संघर्ष होना ये इनेविटेबल था, ये होना ही था, क्योंकि मुगल किसी भी इंडिपेंडेंट शक्ति को पसंद नहीं करते थे, उनको दबाते थे और उनको सरेंडर करने के लिए मजबूर करते थे, और मराठे अपने आप को आजाद रखना चाहते थे, तो सो दैट कॉन्फ्लिक्ट वॉज इनेविटेबल. शिवाजी अंडरस्टूड इट, एंड उन्होंने इस बात को समझा था, और इसलिए उन्होंने महाराष्ट्र से दूर तक, जिंजी तक अपना पूरा नेटवर्क फैलाया था. महाराष्ट्र एंड जिंजी इज फार अवे, जिंजी इज और नियर मद्रास, नियर चेन्नई, और वहां तक उन्होंने किले जीते थे. एंड इट देर वेर चेन ऑफ फोर्ट फ्रॉम महाराष्ट्र टू जिंजी वेयर ही केप्ट हिज मराठा कमांडर्स. नाउ हियर वन थिंग हैज हैपन, औरंगजेब की जो नीतियां थी वो अकबर की तरह लिबरल नहीं थी. ही वॉज नॉट एज लिबरल एज अकबर, एंड एट अ टाइम वी फाइंड दैट ही वॉज क्वाइट एन ऑर्थोडॉक्स. एंड बिकॉज ऑफ हिज पॉलिसी द राजपूत्स हु वेर सपोर्टर्स ऑफ द मुगल एम्पायर दे रिवॉल्टेड अगेंस्ट हिम. यू नो ही औरंगजेब हैज फॉलोड क्वाइट एन अनवाइज पॉलिसी. ही री इम्पोज जिजिया ऑन हिंदूज, ही ब्रोक सर्टन हिंदू टेम्पल्स, एंड एट द सेम टाइम जो जसवंत सिंह राठौड़ जो थे जोधपुर के राजा, ही वॉज अ किंग ऑफ जोधपुर एज वेल एज ही वॉज सपोर्टर ऑफ द मुगल. ही लाइक यू नो अगेंस्ट शिवाजी ऑल्सो ही फॉट. ही केम टू डेक्कन जब शिवाजी ने लाल महल पे शाइस्ते खान के ऊपर आक्रमण किया था. दैट टाइम हिज आर्मी वॉज स्टेशन नियर नियर कोंढाणा. वेल सो यू नो दिस जसवंत सिंह राठौड़ ही वॉज सेंट टू फाइट अगेंस्ट द रिवॉल्टिंग पठान इन अफगानिस्तान एंड देयर ही डाइज. नाउ हिज वाइफ वॉज इन अ फैमिली वे, वो माँ बनने वाली थी, और उनको औरंगजेब ने अरेस्ट कर लिया. और उनका जो बेटा था अजीत सिंह उसको उसने मुस्लिम बनाने की कोशिश की. और वो जो राठौड़ों का जो राज्य था जोधपुर का, ही सेड कि नाउ एज यू डोंट हैव अ किंग दैट इज नाउ एसिमिलेटेड इन द मुगल एम्पायर. एंड दिस हैज क्रिएटेड अ काइंड ऑफ डिसलाइक इन इन द माइंड्स ऑफ द राठौड़ राजपूत एंड दे रिवोल्टेड अगेंस्ट औरंगजेब. यू नो दे अजीत सिंह जो थे जिनको औरंगजेब ने कैद कर रखा था उसको छुड़ाया गया. देर वॉज अ वेरी वेरी वेल नोन पर्सन, वेल नोन फाइटर, दुर्गादास राठौड़. इफ यू एनी टाइम गो टू राजस्थान और यू कैन जस्ट गूगल इट, दुर्गादास राठौड़ इज अ वेरी वेल नोन. आज भी राजस्थान में कहावत है कि बेटा हो तो दुर्गादास जैसा. यू नो ही वॉज अ वेरी लॉयल कमांडर ऑफ राठौड़. एंड दिस राठौड़ दे रिवोल्टेड और उनको देख के फिर बाकी कुछ राजपूत दे ऑल्सो ज्वाइन. और औरंगजेब की जो नीतियाँ थी राजपूतों के खिलाफ दैट वॉज नॉट लाइक बाई हिज ओन सन. सो यू नो एट वन टाइम औरंगजेब सेंट हिज सन अकबर, डोंट कन्फ्यूज विद दिस अकबर विद अर्लियर अकबर. अर्लियर अकबर वॉज अ किंग फ्रॉम 1556 टू 1605 एम्परर, एंड दिस अकबर वॉज प्रिंस अकबर सन ऑफ औरंगजेब. तो ये अकबर के साथ में आर्मी औरंगजेब ने भेजी राजस्थान में, बट एज अकबर डिड नॉट लाइक द पॉलिसीज ऑफ औरंगजेब अगेंस्ट राजपूत, सो ही ज्वाइंट्स हैंड्स विद राजपूत. एंड देन राजपूत एंड अकबर दे वेर रेडी टू फाइट अगेंस्ट अकबर. दे राजपूत हैड अ प्लान कि वी विल रिमूव औरंगजेब एंड वी विल मेक अकबर एज द नेक्स्ट एम्परर. बट यू नो औरंगजेब वॉज वेरी क्लेवर. एक जहां पर वो दोनों कैंप लगे थे, एक तरफ राजपूतों का और अकबर का कैंप था और एक तरफ औरंगजेब का कैंप था, और उस समय औरंगजेब की सेना कम थी. अगर राजपूत अटैक करते थे तो औरंगजेब शायद हार जाता. बट औरंगजेब प्लेड अ वेरी क्लेवर पॉलिसी एंड यू नो ही मेड सम लेटर्स टू बी रिटन टू हिज सन. उस लेटर में लिखा था कि आपने बहुत अच्छा किया राजपूतों को लेके आ गए, नाउ ऑल दिस राजपूत विल बी किल्ड, यू अटैक फ्रॉम वन साइड एंड आई विल अटैक फ्रॉम अनदर साइड. एंड ही इंश्योर्ड दैट दिस लेटर्स आर फॉलिंग इन द हैंड्स ऑफ द राजपूत. सो राजपूत दे स्टार्टेड बिलीविंग दैट प्रोबेबली ये सब अकबर का षड्यंत्र है, वो दोनों सेनाओं के बीच में राजपूतों को लाके उनको मारना चाहता है. एंड देन राजपूत दे जस्ट लेफ्ट द कैम्प, दे अटैक अकबर. एंड व्हेन इट वाज रिवील्ड दैट इट वाज ऑल कॉन्स्पिरेसी, इट वाज टू लेट, ऑल द कैंप वाज डिसऑर्गेनाइज्ड एंड औरंगजेब अटैक एंड द राजपूत्स वर डिफीटेड. अकबर हैज टू रन अवे. नाउ अकबर हु वाज विद दुर्गादास राठौड़, दैट अकबर नाउ ही थॉट वेयर शुड आई गो, एंड नाउ ही फाउंड आउट दैट देयर इज ओनली वन पर्सन हु कैन गिव हिम शेल्टर अगेंस्ट द पावरफुल एम्परर औरंगजेब, एंड दैट इज मराठा किंग. एंड ही कम्स टू महाराष्ट्र. यू नो देयर वाज अ करेस्पोंडेंस एंड ही कम्स टू महाराष्ट्र. एंड देन हियर many times it is believed that though the Mughal prince came to Sambhaji, Sambhaji did not take an adequate make an adequate use of it. But there was a difference between the planning of these two. Akbar Marathon ki aur Rajputo ki help leke badshah banna chahta tha, aur Sambhaji aur Durgadas Rathod जो कि राजपूत कमांडर थे, इन दोनों का आपस में जो करेस्पॉन्डेंस था उसका आशय ये था कि अकबर एक नॉमिनल सम्राट रहेगा और उसके बाद में जो भी सत्ता रहेगी वो राजपूत और मराठों के हाथ में रहेगी, हिंदुओं के हाथ में रहेगी। तो ये प्लानिंग में एक बेसिक डिफरेंस था, दोनों एक दूसरे का इस्तेमाल करना चाहते थे। एंड ये जो अकबर जब महाराष्ट्र में आ गया, एंड दिस हैज एंगर्ड औरंगजेब, क्यों? औरंगजेब ने सब तरफ फरमान निकाले गए थे कि प्रिंस अकबर हैज रिवोल्टेड अगेंस्ट मी, ही इज अ रिबेलियस प्रिंस एंड नोबडी शुड गिव हिम शेल्टर, बट संभाजी हैज डेयर टू गिव हिम शेल्टर। औरंग जो अकबर जो था मराठो, एक पाली नाम की जगह है, वहां पर उसने इस शाहजादा की व्यवस्था कर दी, जहां पर ये प्रिंस रहता था, उसको कुछ सेना भी दी गई। सो फॉलोइंग अकबर, औरंगजेब केम टू महाराष्ट्र विथ ह्यूज आर्मी। इट इज बिलीव दैट ही नियरली हैड 10 लाख आर्मी, एंड देन ही कम्स टू बुरानपुर इन नवंबर 1681, 5 लाख, नियरली 5 लाख कैवलरी एंड 5 लाख इन्फेंट्री, एंड मार्च 1682 ही कम्स टू औरंगाबाद। नाउ अकबर ही स्टेड इन महाराष्ट्र फॉर अ वेरी लॉन्ग पीरियड, ऑलमोस्ट सिक्स सेवन ईयर्स, एंड ही फाउंड आउट दैट संभाजी इज प्रॉबली नॉट विलिंग टू ज्वाइन हैंड्स विथ हिम, नॉट डूइंग एनीथिंग, एंड संभाजी हैड हिज ओन इश्यूज बिकॉज ही न्यू दैट एज द मुगल हैव इन्वेडेड हिज ओन टेरिटरी, इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर हिम टू मार्शल एन आर्मी टुवर्ड्स नॉर्थ एंड कॉन्कर दिल्ली एंड मेक अकबर एज द नेक्स्ट एम्परर। ही हैज टू प्रोटेक्ट हिज लैंड फर्स्ट। And then they developed certain differences. One of the important difference was that, Sambhaji has given a necklace as a gift to Prince Akbar. And Prince Akbar, he had a concubine who was Hindu first. She was converted to Islam by Akbar. And he gifted this necklace to his concubine. And when Sambhaji got news of it, he was furious. He asked, I gave you gift as a necklace and you are giving it to your concubine? And Akbar, he very arrogantly said, ki, I am a king, I am an emperor, I will do whatever I like. And this has created a rift between these two. Sambhaji has withdrawn the army and the privileges that was given to Akbar. And Akbar, he finally left the Maratha kingdom. He first went to Portuguese, and from with the help of the Portuguese, by giving money, he arranged a ship to go to Iran. But then he goes to Iran, but then he dies in 1704 as a very unfortunate prince. And there is a correspondence between a father and son, like Prince Akbar and Aurangzeb. But Akbar episode was important for Maratha-Mughal relationship during Sambhaji's period, because Akbar has taken shelter with Sambhaji, and it is while chasing Akbar that Aurangzeb, he enters Maharashtra. But Sambhaji, one of the acquisition of historian is that Sambhaji could not play this card, his card very well. Akbar was not very effective, not very useful to Sambhaji as such. Well, now let us talk about the war that took place between Sambhaji and Mughal. So, the early phase, the Sambhaji's rule was from 1600 and 80, 1681 to 1600 and sorry, 1680 to 1689, 9 years rule. Out of this 9 year rule, we find that first 4 or 5 years of rule, Sambhaji was quite active. And though the Mughal has invaded with a huge force, he is active in all the front. He is fighting against Mughal, he is fighting against Portuguese, he is fighting against Sindhi. And it is after 1684 85 that we find that his hold on the administration is slackening. One after another, the forts were being conquered by the Mughal, and the administration is slipping from his hand, and he is becoming increasingly dependent on Kavi Kalash. And Marathas, we find that one after another, they were leaving Sambhaji and joining hands with the Mughal. So this, let us talk about this active phase and the important battles that were fought between the Marathas and Mughal during this early phase. The first important event is that happened immediately in 1681 is that loot of Burhanpur. Burhanpur was an important city, Mughal city, and the Marathas, they attacked Burhanpur and they looted the Burhanpur and surrounding area for 3 days. The battle it took place between the Marathas and Mughal near Aurangabad, Ahmednagar, and Solapur. As the Mughal came in huge number, we find that battles were fought at different places. And Aurangzeb, he made a very well planned strategy to surround Sambhaji from all direction. So as I said, he came to Deccan with nearly 10 lakh army. He came with the determination to destroy these three power. That is Qutub Shah of Golconda. Bijapur, Adil Shahi of Bijapur and the Marathas. So he sent letters to when he attacked, his first target was obviously Sambhaji. He always regretted that Shivaji, who came in his hand, has escaped from Agra, and he was bent upon destroying Marathas now, as he believed that Sambhaji has given him provocation by sheltering the rebellious prince Akbar. And Aurangzeb, he sends letter to Siddi, Portuguese, British, Adil Shah and Qutub Shah that they should not do any help to Sambhaji, otherwise it will be considered as an act against the emperor. And Hasan Ali with 14,000 cavalry was sent to conquer North Kokon from Sambhaji. And when this was happening, Sambhaji was engaged in his fight against Siddi. So here we find that Sambhaji was probably not as clever as Shivaji. Shivaji, if you remember, Shivaji always ensured that when he is fighting against Bijapur, he ensured that he is on a friendly term with the Mughals. And when he is fighting against Mughal, he ensured that Bijapur remained quiet. You know, that was a kind of diplomatic success that Shivaji had achieved. But Sambhaji probably could not do it. Nevertheless, he was brave. And Hasan Ali, with his army, he entered North Kokon and he defeated Marathas and he captured Kalyan and he destroyed villages in January 1682. Now, Sambhaji, he comes back to Raigarh and he took adequate precaution that the capital is protected. Kalyan was later on recaptured by the Marathas. Then there was a fort of Ramsej, which was attacked by the Mughal commander Shihabuddin. He was sent in April 1682. And the siege, it continued for 6 months without any success. The Marathas, they fought very valiantly and Shihabuddin was called back. Bahadur Khan was appointed, but he was also not very successful. And finally, the siege was lifted. it was quite a disappointment for the emperor. But nevertheless, Mughal had one credit that when Hambir Rao was sent against the Mughal to help the Marathas, he was defeated by the Mughal. Then in 1682, Kalyan, which was liberated by the Marathas, was recaptured by the Mughal commander Ranamastha Khan. And the Maratha commander Nirupant Pingre and Rupaji Bhosle, they were sent by Sambhaji with the army. These both Maratha commanders were defeated by Ranamastha Khan. So, you know, the war continued one after another, like the royal elephants were captured by the Marathas, but they were again recaptured by the Mughal. Hasan Ali, one of the Mughal commander, was injured in the war that took place near the fort called Parinda. And, you know, at Dharur, important war took place between the Mughal and Marathas. And in this war, the wife of Prince Azam, Jani Begum, she fought valiantly against the Marathas. You know, Rajputs were the supporter of the Mughal even during this phase also. So Aniruddha Singh Handa was the Rajput, and the queen, the wife of Prince Azam, they fought valiantly against the Marathas. Now Ranamastha Khan and Rohilla Khan, though they acquired certain victories against the Marathas, but they were in a very difficult situation in the Kokan Ghat, and Aurangzeb was not finding a way how he can defeat the Marathas. So, you know, the war was going on, but no noticeable success was achieved by the Mughal. And in 1683, Aurangzeb, he called the meeting of all the important Maratha commander. And there were rumors that the Prince Shah Alam, another son of Aurangzeb, is conspiring against his own father and he is joining hands with the Marathas. And Aurangzeb was not willing to trust anybody. He always feared that somebody is going to kill him, somebody is going to assassinate him. And he even thought of leaving for the north. But he really did not find anybody who is capable to continue war against the Marathas. And he became suspicious of his own son and Noble, that these people are having some understanding, some conspiracy against him, and they're joining hand with the Marathas. Even Diler Khan, Diler Khan, the name of Diler Khan comes repeatedly because he was there in South and he fought against Marathas. He was there during the Treaty of Purandar. It was Diler Khan that Sambhaji has joined hands with. And then later on developed the process. So Diler Khan was called for a meeting, and Diler Khan, he feared that probably he's suspected of being a treacherous. He's being suspected of joining hands with the Marathas, and Diler Khan, he commits suicide. The meeting, as I said, the meeting was held between the Mughal commander, emperor called them, and the plan was revived. Now, this was when all this was happening. Sambhaji, he continued to fight against Portuguese and Savans of Konkan, which was again a tactical mistake on his part, because his energy is now divided into the different fronts. He could have, done something to maintain peace with this other power so that he can concentrate on against the war that was going on against the Mughal. Now, after this meeting, Shah Alam was sent to Konkan with a huge force. Shihabuddin was sent to Pune. Shah Alam was sent towards Nashik. And Mughal Aurangzeb, he took precaution that Sambhaji is not getting help from Bijapur and Golconda. The Mughal, they looted the Maratha places like Shahpur and Shamgav. In 1683, Shah Alam, he goes to Sawantwadi area, that is in Konkan. And during this time, as I said, Sambhaji was engaged with the war in Portuguese. So as Portuguese were about to be defeated, but as Shah Alam came on the Marathas with a huge army, Sambhaji, he had an agreement with the Portuguese, stopped the war, and he come back to meet the challenge of Shah Alam. So the battle was fought between Shah Alam and Sambhaji, and large number of people on both sides were killed in Konkan, but the battle was indecisive. However, Sambhaji comes back to Raigad. And, a priest Akbar, who had taken shelter with the Marathas, he was placed at Dicholi, and Aurangzeb sent another of his son, that is Shah Alam, to attack Akbar. And Akbar was attacked at Dicholi with a huge army, 60,000 infantry, 40,000 cavalry, 20,100 elephant. And Akbar was, he not having such huge army. He warned Portuguese that Portuguese should not give food and fodder to Mughals. Now this has angered Prince Alam, Shah Alam, and he burned the Maratha area, Kudal, Banda, Dicholi, Malwan, and he also looted the place called Wengurla. And but in spite of that, the Mughals, they in Konkan, they were not getting adequate food, and there was an epidemic, and that led to the death of nearly one third Mughal army. And finally, the Prince Shah Alam was badly disappointed. Expedition did not earn him anything. Large number of people were killed, and this disappointed prince, he comes back to Emperor to Aurangabad in 1684. In 1684, Shahabuddin Khan, he attacks the Maratha kingdom Raigad, Maratha capital Raigad, and he burned and looted the place called Pachad near Raigad. And he also, now you see, as I told you, 1684 onwards or so, we find that the Sambhaji is gradually losing his hold over the administration. Even now, the Mughals, they manage to turn some of the Sambhaji's people against him, and they join hands with the Mughal. Singhgad was captured by Abdul Kader, and though the Marathas, they continue to resist, like the Mughal territory like Dharangav and Khandesh, they were looted by the Marathas. Numerous battles were fought between the Marathas and Mughal at different places, and they looted each other territories. Burhanpur was again threatened by the Marathas, and Aurangzeb had to take a lot of precautions so that Burhanpur is protected. Now 3 years, now war, it's Aurangzeb came in 1681, now 1684. So 3 years the continuous war went on between the Mughals and Maratha, but Mughals did not achieve anything much. Now Aurangzeb, he changed his strategy. He felt that it is probably the Bijapur and Golconda kingdom, they were helping Sambhaji, and they were indeed, because they knew that the Aurangzeb is not going to spare them as well. So Aurangzeb is a common enemy of all the three kingdom, and now he stopped his attack for time being against the Marathas, and he concentrated on Bijapur and Golconda. So he attacked Bijapur and Golconda in 1684. because as he wanted to finish them before he can concentrate completely on the Marathas. So this Bijapur was held by Sambhaji and Golconda, but finally, the Mughal strength was too much, and finally Bijapur surrendered in September 1686. Then next was Golconda. Prince Shah Alam was sent against Golconda, Hyderabad city, which is near the fort of Hyderabad, Golconda fort. That Hyderabad city was captured and looted by the Mughal, and Qutub Shah, he took shelter in the Golconda fort. And in Golconda there was influence of two Brahmin brother, Madanna and Akanna. They were ministers, and there were a number of Brahmins who were holding the high post, though the Sultan was Muslim. And Aurangzeb accused them that you are ruling with the help of the kafir, that is non-Muslim. In order to, you should send their head, kill them. And in order to please Aurangzeb, the Muslim soldiers of Qutub Shah, they killed large number of Brahmins. They were, the Mughal army was surrounding the fort, and these Brahmin officers were killed by the Muslim soldiers, and they were thrown. And even the Madanna was captured and killed, and his head was sent to Aurangzeb, because they believed that probably that will save them, but it did not really happen. Golconda could not be saved, and an officer from Golconda, he joined hands with the Mughal, and the secret way was shown. The Mughal army, they entered the fort, and the Golconda was finished in 1687. And from that Golconda fort, Aurangzeb got huge property of 10 crore. And now with Bijapur and Golconda no more existing, both the princes, the ruler of that area, were captured and kept in the prison by Aurangzeb. Now he renewed his war against the Marathas once again. Sharjah Khan, who was in service of Bijapur, and after the Bijapur kingdom was finished, he joins in service of Aurangzeb. And there were a number of Maratha noble who were in the service of Bijapur. They also joined service of Aurangzeb now. And Mughal, they fought battle against the Maratha forces of Sambhaji, and the commander, the Maratha commander-in-chief, Hambirao Mohite, he was killed in the battle in December 1687. That is the Battle of Wai. Though Marathas won the war, Hambirao Mohite was killed in this battle. And this was a great loss to Sambhaji, because Hambirao Mohite, being a very capable commander-in-chief, was an important supporter of Sambhaji. And now here onward, he became increasingly more and more dependent on Kavi Kalash. Matabar Khan, the Mughal commander, as we see now, 1684 onward, though the Marathas won certain battles, there was a gradual decline. As we see, the picture become very obviously clear that the Mughals, they were now having an upper hand. Mubarak Khan, the Mughal commander, he conquered North Kokan, Vishramgarh, then fort like Malang, Ratangarh, Harshgarh, Tringan Lavadi, Madangarh, near Igatpuri, all these were conquered by the Mughal. And now Trimbakgarh was interestingly conquered by the Mughal by paying money. So we find that Maratha commanders, they were, understanding that probably Sambhaji is losing his grip, he is going to be defeated, and they were joining hands with the Mughal. So Telang Rao in 1689, the commander of that Trimbakgarh, he joined hands with the Mughal, take a lot of money and hand over the fort. In the Mughal Maratha war, it continued in Karnataka as well. Harjiraja Mahadik, the relative of Sambhaji, he continued to fight against the Mughal in Karnataka. And Maratha position in Maharashtra, it became weak, because Sambhaji has to support that war in Karnataka as well. Some part of army was sent to Karnataka. And Sambhaji, he mostly spent his time near Pannargarh, and the Mughal, they were trying to conquer Pannargarh, which was a very important fort. And some Mughal were now trying to surround Sambhaji from all sides. Marathas like Shirke, they had certain enmity with Sambhaji. They also joined hands with the Mughal. And, Kavi Kalash, as I told, was not liked by the Mughal. Kavi Kalash was attacked by Shirke and he was defeated by Shirke, and in retaliation Sambhaji attacked Shirke and killed a large number of family members of Shirke. So Shirke were very angry with Sambhaji and they joined hands with Aurangzeb. They joined Shirke, they joined hands with Aurangzeb. And in February 1689, there was a Sardar called Sheikh Nizam. He was in the service of Qutub Shah earlier, but now as Qutub Shah, he joined service with Aurangzeb. He was placed at Kolhapur and he was given a responsibility of capturing Sambhaji. Because, you know, Kolhapur and Pannagad, they were close by, and Mughal were knowing that Sambhaji is in this area. So Mughal spies, they give him a news that Sambhaji, along with Kavi Kalash and with a very small army, is at a place called Sangameshwar. And from Kolhapur, this Sheikh Nizam, he marched with 2,000 cavalry and 1,000 infantry. And Sambhaji, he got the news that the Mughals are on him, but he did not pay a lot of attention for whatever reason. It is believed that he continued to indulge in merrymaking. There was a possibility that he could have escaped from being captured. And then the Sambhaji and his small army, small people, they were suddenly attacked by this Mughal. Kavi Kalash, he went for fighting, but he was injured. And then Sambhaji and Kavi Kalash, you know, at Sangameshwar, Sambhaji had his palace, and they both hid in the basement, but they were caught by the Mughal. And immediately after being captured, the Mughal commander, they sent information to Aurangzeb, and they were mounted on the elephant, and then they were marched to the Mughal camp at where Aurangzeb was there. And during this procession, Sambhaji was humiliated. He was made to put on the dress that looked like a buffoon, with a tapering cap, and the Mughal soldiers, they continued to abuse Sambhaji and Kavi Kalash. And Sambhaji was not willing to survive this humiliation. And it is believed that when he was presented to Aurangzeb, Aurangzeb dismounted from his throne and prayed to Allah that his mortal enemy, the son of Shivaji, is now captured. And when he was put in the jail, what is to be done with him? It is believed, we are not sure, that Aurangzeb asked him to become Muslim, and when Sambhaji refused, and he also used certain kind of disrespectful word for Prophet Muhammad, and Aurangzeb was very angry at this, and then he finally ordered that Sambhaji and Kavi Kalash should be tortured and killed. And they were tortured for days together. First, like, you know, they as when Aurangzeb and Sambhaji met, you know, it was a custom that you should lower your eyes in front of the emperor. But Aurangzeb Sambhaji looked at him and did not lower his eyes. Aurangzeb was very angry at this, and then he ordered that his eyes to be, you know, gorged out. So he was blinded first, and then his tongue was cut, and then his hands, feet were chopped off, and he was both of them were tortured and finally killed at the place called Korega on 11th March 1689. The head of Sambhaji and Kavi Kalash, it was displayed in the Mughal camp, and then their body were thrown into the bushes. Later on, it was recovered by the people, and then they were cremated, where there is now a kind of a memorial temple in memory of Sambhaji. So, you know, we see that this is how the relation between Sambhaji, trajectory of relation between Sambhaji and our Mughal. So what were the failure of Sambhaji? You know, when he became Maratha king, he had huge force, he had navy also. But in comparison to Aurangzeb, definitely the strength of the Marathas was very less. There is a suspicious, it could be a matter of research, that he was really addicted to certain intoxicant, and that is the reason he could not escape from Sangameshwar. Neither he could maintain hold over the administration. There is a question about his character as well. He had no support of experienced person, as we see that for a variety of reason, the experience nobility of Shivaji, they did not support him. And he did not nurture the talent. There was an important, see, interestingly, there was a person called Qazi Haider, and he was an accountant of Shivaji's period. And this person, Qazi Haider, when Aurangzeb attacked Maratha, Qazi Haider, he went on to Aurangzeb. And Aurangzeb later on sent him to Delhi, and he became a very important person in the Mughal administration at Delhi. So, she, like Shivaji, he Sambhaji was probably not very clever to hold on to the talented people. Akbar, he could not also make a proper use of Akbar. Akbar, he could have made a proper use, and probably that could have created a lot of problem for the Mughal emperor. People left him. We find that Wadikar Khem Sawant, Ram Dalvi, you know, these were the Marathi Konkani people. Probably Sambhaji could not hold on to them for a longer period. And there was a growing indiscipline in the army we see during Sambhaji's period. You know, Shivaji had a very strict instruction to his army that no woman is to be carried off during the time of the war. Women are not to be captured. But we find that during the period of Sambhaji, this discipline was being shattered to pieces. People started carrying women, and they even started capturing. Even during the attack on Portuguese, when the Portuguese fort was captured by the Marathas, the Portuguese nuns were raped by the Maratha soldiers. It is recorded by Kamal Gokhale in her book on Sambhaji. And you know, Shivaji was very dead against in this kind of behavior. He punished his own people if they molested any woman, and we find that there was a general decline. So whatever the case may be, Sambhaji for that 9 years, he at least for the initially 4 or 5 years, he fought on the different front against Mughal, against Portuguese, against Sindhi, and he initially he did fight, but probably during this initial phase he exhausted all his resources, and then we find the administration probably was going out of his hand from 1684 onward. Unfortunately, he was killed, but his death has united Maratha like anything. You know, when the Marathas they came to know about such a gruesome and torturous killing of their king, they temporarily they forget their differences. They join hands together, and even though Rajaram was not as capable as Shivaji, neither grown up, but he was supported by the Marathas. And here onwards, we find that the Marathas they really fought valiantly against Aurangzeb on all front, from Karnataka, Jinji, to Maharashtra, and finally Aurangzeb could not be successful against the Marathas. Of course, that phase, Rajaram's and Tarabai's struggle against Aurangzeb, that we'll be discussing later. In the next, as this unit is exclusively for Sambhaji, next topic we'll be taking, next unit we'll be taking either Sambhaji Portuguese or Sambhaji Siddhi relation. Probably we'll go with Sambhaji and Siddhi because Siddhi was an ally or a vassal of Mughal. So here we are stopping for today. In case you are having any doubt, you can ask.